Everybody, Paul again. Today we're going to do a set of drum brakes on the back of the S10. A couple weeks ago when I went and I was working on the back right side of this truck, it was so hot and humid there's just no way that I was going to get this done. So today we're going to knock that out. So if you're not sure how to change a set of drum brakes, don't go away. We're going to do that now. First thing we're going to do is we're going to jack up the back of the truck. I got a couple jack stands for the axle. We're going to get both back wheels up off the ground. So I'll probably speed this up. One of the things I didn't cover is what happens if this is last in my last video when I was taking off the lug studs. If this is on here really bad, you could take your hammer and you could tap around it, unjar it. If that doesn't work, you could apply some heat and just make sure you're not spraying anything that's flammable. You'd hate to be this your first and last project. Let's take this guy off. Now this guy might be stuck a little bit. I just realized I was such an idiot. So, you're gonna do stupid things, and you're gonna take the back brakes off. Make sure you release the emergency brake first. Oh my God. All right, now that we've got the drum off, drum brakes are pretty easy to understand. There's a few moving parts, and it looks really complicated when you're staring at it like this and you see all these springs and levers. It's pretty simple. This right here going across is the brake cylinder. There's a piston on each end. When you push on the brake fluid comes back, goes through the line, pushes the pistons out on either side, which then pushes the shoe out to touch the inside of the drum. Creates friction, stops the truck. When they let go of that, you have these two return springs. There's one on each side, here and here, and they connect to this center pivot point. Those have to come off. Right back here, you have the handbrake latch, which actually sits behind the shoe. You can't see this, it's behind the spring, but we have basically, right behind this flange, there's the handbrake strut, has a little spring on one side. You wanna remember which side that's on. And here, we've got two hold down springs. These push in, they turn, they pop off. And on this side, you can barely see it, but this is the actuator lever. There's a linkage that comes up from the actuator lever to the top here, and then it comes down here, and there's the actuator lever spring. At the bottom here, we have an adjustment screw assembly, which actually is what keeps the diameter of the pads at a certain distance from the drum, so that when you apply pressure to the drum brake, you're not having to apply more to get more pressure out of these back brakes. There are specialty tools that you can use. Most people won't have, and most people won't buy these tools because it's not that they're necessarily expensive, but they're kind of like one-purpose tools. But they make a specialty tool about pulling these springs off of the center pivot point, and they make a specialty tool for taking these guys off. Don't need it, can accomplish it with some pliers. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take all this off and swap these pads. Okay, that only took 20 minutes to get one spring off. Yay! Alright, so this comes out from behind here. We gotta take this guy, we'll push this in, and then we'll turn that, and then that, the outside piece, the guard, and the spring will come off. Voila! She popped off. And out comes the pin. So, you can see what it looks like there and there. See, not so bad. That was the easiest thing to come off yet. It's getting hot out here. I've actually built like a shade tent over my little work area here because this thing is crazy. There it goes. See, I'm making it worse than it has to be. Just don't lose anything. Just back here, I'm gonna grab this guy. All right.
That's two.
So disjointed, easy, should be. At least that's the rumor. Should be easy to undo. Look at this thing, it's just falling apart. There you go. Oh, we got, see, the plate came off. The pressure plate, look at that. This all comes apart now. Reach back, grab this guy. You need to remember where all this shit goes. Here what we have is the original thing, and I can assume what this is that protective coating that goes around the pad, you know, to keep the metal from corroding, and it's just falling off. It was falling off inside. Look at that, that's just, so far we're into this about a half an hour. It's not too bad. A little bit stiff getting those springs off, but they've been probably on there for quite a while. All right, another thing to check while you're down here is you wanna check the piston up here at the top. You wanna check these, they have some seals, some rubber seals, like gaskets, and you wanna make sure they're not torn or worn. These look pretty good, so we're gonna leave them on. We're not gonna mess with that. Okay, so we've got everything off. We're ready to put in our new pads. So that's pretty straightforward. The pads are actually different sizes. You've got one that has covers more area than the other. If you put them next to each other. If you're smart, you probably took a picture of what you're doing before you took all this apart, so you have some point of reference. And this guy's gonna go there, like that. Okay. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna line this thing up, hold all these pieces together, kind of get that pin right. This can get a little tricky. Once you get going here, you should be okay. Okay, so then we're gonna take this guy. We're gonna push him in like so.
As you see, I'm wearing a different shirt, and there's trash bags over the brakes. After I got the brake pads off and started to work on the truck, storm rolled in, and for the last 2 days we've had nothing but thunder, lightning, a couple tornadoes in the area. So now it's kind of clear, it's in the morning. I'm gonna try and get this done. Okay, so hook that, pull it over here, get that around here. And that is on. This guy right here goes in behind, and you can't really see it. He actually goes in back here, and he's gonna position between this pad and this pad. See, it was that easy. Okay, so I made a mistake and I put the wrong pad on the wrong side, but that just means I got more practice. Now I've got the right pad for the right side, and we're gonna put the left side in this. And we have another spring that holds it here, and then we've got two pieces, one in the middle here, which is this guy right here. And what he's gonna do, this guy's gonna sit like right there, right here. In complete disclosure, I've already taken these apart a couple times trying to refresh my memory on how to do drum brakes, but hopefully this is going to get a lot easier, especially when I move over to the other side. I said, the more parts you put on it, the tighter it gets. Now here comes the ugly part. This guy's got to go all the way around this. And this is not going to be fun. Holy cow, it worked.
So everything's back in place. This is really important that this is actually underneath, that this retention spring's not too bad. You got a set of pliers, you can get that in. You lay these back. You see, we put this guy in here. Make sure you're wearing some protective lenses. You're gonna turn that, and if you don't get it right, it's gonna pop off and hit you in the forehead. It hit me. These springs, I thought were a lot harder to get off the first time and second time and third time. Every time I was putting them back on, I was making mistakes. So then this is the toughest part, really, honestly, right here is on the back side. You've got this kind of like retention holder that mounts to the back of the dust plate on the back here. But you have a spring right here that's going to come up and it's going to catch. And that's meant to keep the tension on this guy. So when he turns, or when the brakes kind of do their thing, I keep hitting my elbow. And then these springs up here were kind of a bitch, to be honest with you. Other than that, I mean, once you've done it once, I mean, it seems to go a lot easier the second time around. So, I mean, I had made the mistake. I put this smaller pad on the back, and I was supposed to put the bigger pad back here. And so once I got it all on there, I realized I'd put the wrong pad on the back. So only took me a couple seconds to take it all out and put it all back in. So once you get a little bit of practice at it, it's not a big deal.
Okay, so what we're doing now is the brakes are on there. Everything's back, the drum's on there. We're gonna do a test, and we're gonna test the emergency and the regular brakes by me just hand spinning it. I've done a brake job years ago and those were disc brakes, and I didn't really test it very thoroughly before I went out on the road, and I went about 3 miles and locked up and tore up a rotor. So we're going, I'm not gonna expect this to happen. But as you can see here, I've got good rotation, and I've got Tyler in the truck. Tyler, why don't you hit the emergency for me? No, there's nothing. So this thing is not turning. Okay, go ahead and release the emergency. I got rotation again. I'm good. Okay. Tyler, now why don't you hit the regular brakes for me? I'm doing a stop. Full stop. You stopping?
Yeah.
It's spinning.
Brakes all the way down.
No, that's not good. What's going on here? I can feel that engage. Now release it hard. Okay, it released. Foot on the brake. Yeah, I felt it that time, but it's still turning. Why is it still turning? Foot on the brake. Feel an engage over there. Not seeing it here. Let me crawl under here, see what's going on. Off the brake.
I'm not on it.
Foot on the brake.
Push it down?
Yeah. It sounds like I hear air. That's what I hear. I hear air. Do it again.
I didn't have my foot off, it's still on it.
Take it off.
Okay.
Brake. Okay, it's coming from the other side.
So the other brake stopped working, and I think we figured out the problem on the right side. I don't know if you guys saw that, but there's a brake fluid shooting out of the drum brake on the right side out of the piston. So that explains why the brakes don't work all of a sudden. So it looks like it got a busted seal. So I'll have to go get a replacement, and then we'll have to fix that on this side.
Well, that's all we have for today. I thought I was going to be able to get those rear brakes done, but it looks like because the pressure buildup, the right cylinder boot broke, and now I have to go buy two cylinders, one for each side, because you should replace those in pairs. Stay tuned on our next episode while we swap those cylinders. We're going to bleed the brakes. I'm going to check the brakes. I'm going to show you a way to check the brakes without actually putting the car on the ground. If you're not 100% comfortable with changing brakes, it's a pretty serious thing, so you should take it to a professional. Otherwise, if you feel like you're somewhat technically inclined, you feel like you can do the job, I think there's enough information to show you how to change brakes on the basic truck. Now, there can be differences between vehicles, but the overall concepts are the same, and hopefully this video helped you guys out a little bit today, so stay tuned next week, and we'll get back on that.
So here's your motivation. You're the eye candy of the shot, so you gotta lay down. Can you lay down? Don't be a prima donna. You know, for not being paid, you sure have a lot of attitude. Yeah, well, screw you too. Need a better actress. My actress quit. Yeah, she wasn't that good looking anyways.
What the hell, man? Subscribe already.